Alright, greetings and salutations. My name is Comic Fire, and welcome back for more NIER. In the last episode, we really started screwing over the area on accident. In this episode, I don't know, let's see if we can fix it. Some armored shade thingamadoodle. See how many dark hands it can take? The answer is a lot.
Why did you have to come? It was fine until you were here.
All right, you go down next. Oh, goodbye. Boy, an armored massive shade. I just realized what this was. Start picking off his armor bit by bit. Coming from some guy who wasn't coming out to see me.
I can't stand it anymore.
Is that one guard just sitting there chilling all crumpled up? I like the crumple stilts game, am I right? There we go. Looking. Wait, I take it back.
By my pages, is this beast a shade as well?
That thing sucked up the villagers.
Stop! They killed them all! I can't!
Talking.
I feel something from within the bone.
Oh my lord. This is another boss that can only be damaged with magic, but I also don't really intend to, you know, go up and try to whack it with my spear.
I think those are people!
Darn it!
Oh,
Oh my god, it's like Hive Mind from Dead Space. Unfortunately, these guys seem to be a little bit weaker than the other ones. Take back what I said about Armor Break being a useless skill. That would have been wonderful here. Actually, let's get some words set up at this inopportune time. Magic. Dark Lance is going to get... wait. Gebuloth. And Drain MP.
Defeating the smaller enemies has no effect on the leader!
But I feel like that did a good chunk of damage to it. Satisfyingly big punch. Or we can get rid of those tentacles. Beautiful. Oh, that's a lot of blood. Oh dear god, Emil, you taught it something.
Look out! Something's coming!
That's all on you, kid. Oh damn. Oh damn.
I'll pin it down!
Yes, please. Yes, let's
attack it from above.
Do that.
Emil!
I'll keep it busy! You should be able to attack from behind! Go around!
Try him!
Please! Hurry!
Whoop, dead.
The lad can take care of himself. We must circle to the creature's rear.
I don't know, they're trying to make you move this quickly.
Closer. You cannot harm it from below.
Get a little sloppy. I can't really hit it from there either.
Move closer. You cannot harm it from below.
Alright, guys, hold up.
Are you there yet?
Boy, you are not making this easy, Wendy. Black ones don't seem to be able to be hit by magic. I guess that prevents you from just holding down R1 and winning the game. Balloon.
Carefully, Mia. It won't help anyone if we lose you here.
beat the hell out of that thing! How can it still move?
Its combined powers are beyond even my greatest suspicion. Unless we slay the core, all hope is lost.
All right, you all. You're gonna help me kill that big thing. Give me your MP. Good chunk. Good chunk. Suffice to say, I think that did it.
Emil? Emil Weiss? He's gone. His instincts have taken hold. The ultimate weapon is being deployed.
You saved our lives. Didn't you? If it wasn't for you, we'd all be dead. We owe you. It's all right.
Sacrifice is right, god damn. I don't know, I'm starting to feel like maybe our mission isn't for the best now. A lot of people are dying. Of course, it's the Shade's fault, isn't it? We're just killing Shades.
Thank you.
They're not the bad guys, right? Of course, judging from what those people said, you know. It's just a little... Those people seem to be okay with the idea of shades and even human relationships being a thing. I don't know. Maybe I'm just thinking too hard, after all. Let's see if we got a fun little letter. Oh, hey. Banging. So I realized we probably could have talked to Popola, considering she is right here. And zoom! Wonder if I can trigger that, weird little glitch. Oh, never mind. It was the one during the side quest video that, I did. Where we ran the boar in here and the game freaked out. I wouldn't mind doing that again. I like triggering, little glitches. It's always fun. It's like I'm doing something the game developers didn't intend or want for me to do. It's like sticking it to the man, yo. Except I'm sitting here playing a video game talking to my laptop. Ain't much of a rebel. Just a guy sitting here talking to my laptop. Hey there, Spencer.
Hey there. Your weapon is ready to go.
Great.
We get the two-handed sword, Iron Will.
You know, with a weapon like that...
You were going to say?
I need to ask you for a favor.
Oh, yeah?
I want you to avenge my brother.
That's a rather ponderous favor.
It's my mission. It's why I've been creating these weapons for the past 4 years. I don't care about money. I only care about making a weapon strong enough to kill those bastards.
What bastards?
The ones in the mountain. That little shade and his robot.
There are shades here?
Your brother was killed by a shade?
Yes.
And what have we decided, hmm?
It's killing.
Oh, yeah. So now we get to repeat that entire thing. I think. That entire, that entire dungeon. Unless this is a shortcut. Which it does not appear to be. Why does that room exist? Well, at least it'll, give us a much needed experience. Of course, that Shade boss gave us a ton of experience and got us really close to, leveling again. But yeah, remember that big, empty room? That was the last place we went to? That's our destination. Yes, unfortunately, this part gets a slight repetitive, but, in all honesty, We're nearing in on endgame. In fact, I imagine that in two more episodes, we'll be down to the final dungeon. Of course, I do want to get some side questing done prior to that. Yes, we still have the other 49% of the side quests to do. I also would like to get an on-screen platinum trophy, but that one's going to take a little more time on my part. Also, this game has DLC. If you didn't know that. It's a story mission. Or, not a story mission, but it's extra story that, you know, wasn't in the game originally. It's called The World of the Recycled Vessel. And I'm gonna cover that too. This LP is actually paid for itself, so I bought the DLC and... Well, I haven't bought it yet, but very soon I will purchase the DLC, and then I'm gonna probably do that. That'll be a post thing, because I've never played it, and from what I've heard, you need a very high level NIER to do it. Like, I'm talking like level 35 to be able to comfortably do everything in the DLC without being like one-shotted like we were with that boar in the beginning of the LP. And I'm in the interest of showing you guys things that doesn't involve me getting one-shotted. I like to pretend that I'm a cooler guy than I actually am. Alright, here we have another large shade. Well, robot thingamadoodle. We're significantly stronger than we used to be. She picked up a new trick too, I don't remember that last time. Not to get turned around this time. And let's get a health salve, I guess. And these two things, because I'm greedy for things I don't need. Because I like money. Alright, let's pull these guys out of the sky. Mine, mine. Haven't hit me yet. Figured you guys would have put in a little more work in my absence. Someone's gotta farm these materials. Do all the hard work and I'll reap the rewards. This is how things work here in America. I don't think there are any real limits to how many of, like, these severed cables and broken arms and whatnot you can pick up. Ooh, rare item. I think they cap out at, like, 99 or something. It's not something stupid like 20. That would be silly. Not in the interest of silly. Actually, no. Silly's kind of cool. Just not in this case. Of course, I don't really know anyone who could climb upstairs like this. I know in Metal Gear Solid 2, he tried to flip upstairs like that, right, and would just fall on his back. I thought it was kind of funny. How do we even know the robot's down there? We just assume because it was a big ol' arena? I can dig it. Anyway, I think I'm gonna end the episode here. So, does the robot lie down the hole? Find out next time on NIER. See you guys then.